In this video, we are going to solve some problems on the diode circuit analysis. We are going to apply the methodology that we learned in the previous video of assume, solve, and check. And at the same time, we're going to use the diode models that we learned in the previous videos. Okay, so let's start with this simple example. We have just a source, 10 kilo ohm, and the diode connected in this way. It's clear that this circuit is very easy to predict whether the diode will be on or off, but let's assume here that we don't know. Let's pretend that we don't know whether the diode will be on or off. Although it's clear that we are connecting about 10 volt in this direction, so the 10 volt will try to push the current in the regular direction of the diode, so the diode will be on. But let's pretend that we don't know, and let's pretend that we are going to assume that the diode is off in the beginning, we solve, and then we check. But here the problem, it says, assume that we have ideal diodes. So we are using the ideal diode model. And then the first step, as we agreed, is assume. We'll say assume. This is how we are going to solve problems in exams, quizzes, homeworks. You have to write assume. Assume that the diode is off. Let's assume, pretend that we don't know, and we'll assume that the diode is off. And then you plot the circuit. If the diode is off, this means that it will be represented by an open circuit. Right? And then this is 10 volt, this resistor is 10 kilo ohm, and the current of the diode is here, and the voltage of the diode, this is the voltage of the diode. So now, the second step, this is assumption, assume, we assume that the diode is off, we replace it by an open circuit, and then the second step is we solve. We solve for the voltage and the current of the diode. Of course, this is a very simple circuit, we see that the current of the diode will be zero, right? And since the current is zero, there is no voltage drop in the resistor here, and the voltage of the diode will be the same as 10 volt. And now we check. We assume that the diode is off, but we found that our diode voltage is greater than zero. We have an ideal diode, right? We assumed ideal diode. And in ideal diode, if we assume that the diode is off, then the voltage of the diode must be less than or equal zero. But here we found that the voltage of the diode is greater than zero. Is it possible for the diode to be off while the voltage of it is greater than zero? Impossible, right? Impossible. In order for the diode to be off, the voltage of the diode must be less than or equal zero. So here we say wrong assumption. Wrong assumption. And then we repeat the steps again. We'll go and say assume again, assume that the diode is on. And since we are using the ideal diode model, the diode is on means we assume it's a short circuit, right? We'll assume it's a short circuit. So the circuit will look like this. 10 volt here, 10 kilo ohm, and the diode is short circuit. This is the current of the diode, this is the voltage of the diode. And then we solve this circuit. Of course, the solution again of this circuit is very easy. The voltage of the diode, because the diode is short circuit, the voltage of the diode will be zero. The current of the diode will be what? The current of the diode will be 10 over 10 kilo ohm. So it will be 1 milliampere. And then we check. How do we check here? How do we check here? For the diode that is on, we said that we check for the current greater than or equal zero. So here we found that the current, which is 1 milliampere, is greater than or equal zero. Then we say that our assumption is correct. And since our assumption is correct, this means that this is the solution of our problem. The important point here that you should take care of is that if you solve based on a certain assumption and then you find that the assumption is wrong, then you completely forget about everything that you solved here. Don't use any value that you calculated here in the wrong assumption, because since your assumption was wrong, all the values that you calculated here, all of them are wrong. You forget about them, clear them from your mind, and start a brand new solution. completely new solution from the beginning. Calculate all the values again from the beginning. Don't use anything from the wrong solution. I will leave this problem to you to solve. If we reverse the diode, you can, of course, here the diode will be off. It's clear, but you can pretend that you don't know. Assume that the diode is on first and see whether the current will be greater than zero or not. And the current of the diode, of course, the current of the diode will be is defined in the conventional direction of the current of the diode is up, right? So when you calculate the current in this circuit, you will find that the current will be going in this direction. The actual current will be going in this direction, which means that the current of the diode is negative. So it's impossible for the diode to be on and its current is negative, and your assumption will be wrong. I will leave this to you. The next example is we are going to solve exactly the same circuit that we solved, but using constant voltage drop model. Okay, so what we'll do is, again, we are going to use constant voltage drop model for the same example that we solved, okay? In the constant voltage drop model, if we assume that the diode is off, it will be open circuit. If we assume that the diode is on, it will be a battery, right? So it's constant voltage drop model. First, assume that the diode is off. Again, pretend that we don't know. Assume that the diode is off. It will be open circuit. Again, this is the current of the diode. This is the voltage of the diode. This is 10 kilo ohm. And this is 10 volt. In this case, VID, of course, second step solve, I diode will be zero, open circuit, right? V diode will be 10 volt, and then check, we'll find, similar to the previous problem, we'll find that VD, which is 10 volt, this is greater than the VDO. VDO is given as 0.6, so we'll find that VD is greater than VDO, which means that our assumption is wrong, because it's impossible that VD is greater than VDO and the diode is off, right? So this is wrong assumption. Then we forget everything that we did here, and we repeat the problem again. We say, again, assume that the diode is on. In this case, we are going to replace the diode with its model. This is a constant voltage drop, so we replace the diode with a battery of VDO, which is 0.6. This is 10 kilo ohm, this is 10 volt, okay? And then this is the voltage of the diode, this is the current of the diode. Of course, the voltage of the diode here is 0.6, and the volt, and the current of the diode will be what? The current of the diode is the current in this circuit, which is 10 minus 0.6 over 10 kilo ohm. 10 volt minus 0.6 over 10 kilo ohm. This will give you 9.4 milliampere. Then we check, you'll find that since we assume that the diode is on, our check is the current. We should check for the current. The current ID must be greater than zero, and here we found it to be 9.4 milliampere, which is greater than or equal zero, then our assumption is correct, and we solved the problem, right? And we solved the problem. You can try this, you can try the piecewise linear model with the same problem and with the previous problem with the diode reversed. And you can just train yourself with any problem that we solve, any problem that you find. You can try the ideal model, you can try the constant voltage drop model, you can try the piecewise linear model as a matter of training for you. Now let's solve another higher level example. In this example, we have two diodes, okay, 15 volt here. It's like a source 15 volt. 10 kilo ohm, then diode number one to the ground, diode number two here, connected to point E, then 5 kilo ohm, then to another source of negative 10 volt. This is our circuit. We are required to assume ideal diodes. We are required to solve this circuit assuming ideal diodes, D1 and D2, both of them are ideal. And we need to solve this circuit for all the currents, all the voltages in the circuit. And then after we solve, we need to check that our assumption for these diodes are correct. So let's start by first step, assume. We look at the circuit and we need to assume something that makes sense. So here it seems that we are connecting both the anode of both diodes to a positive voltage. The cathode is connected to a low volt here. The cathode is connected to a low voltage here. So it makes sense to assume in the beginning that both diodes are on. Both diodes are on. In this case, if we assume that both diodes are on and we are using the ideal diode model, then we replace them with short circuits. So the circuit will look like this. Here, the first diode will be short circuit, and the second diode will be also short circuit, going to a resistor. Then here we have negative 10 volt, and this is 5 kilo ohm, this is 10 kilo ohm, and here we have 15 volt. Of course, when we connect diode number one is a short circuit, we connect this point to ground, so this point will be 0 volt. So the first step is assume. Second step, we need to solve. We need to solve for what? Solve everything about this circuit. Solve everything about this circuit. So this is the voltage of diode number one. This is the voltage of diode number two. This is the current of diode number two. This is the current of diode number one. Let's try to solve for these currents. Of course, VD1 and VD2, we assume they are on, so short circuit. So both of them are zero. We need to calculate ID1 and ID2. ID1, it's very difficult to calculate directly. Why? Because this is a short circuit. The voltage here is zero, the voltage here is zero. We don't know how to calculate the current in this short circuit. But the only way to calculate the current in this short circuit is to calculate the current here in the 10 kilo ohm. Then we subtract ID2 from it. Okay, we'll get ID1. So let's calculate the current I. The current I in the 10 kilo ohm is 15 minus 0 over 10. 15 minus 0 over 10 kilo ohm. This will give you 1.5 milliampere. And then we can also calculate the current ID2. ID2 will be the voltage here, which is 0, minus the voltage here, which is negative 10. So 0, negative, negative 10, divided over 5 kilo ohm. This will give you 2 milliampere. Now we can calculate ID1. ID1 in diode number 1 equals I minus ID2, which will be I is 1.5 milli minus ID2, which is 2 milli. So ID1 will be minus 0.5 milliampere, negative 0.5 milliampere. Now let's check. Step number 3 is check. We assume that both diodes are on, right? So we need to check the current. We'll find that ID2 is greater than 0. Then this means that our assumption is correct for diode number 2. But we found that ID1 is negative. ID1 is negative 0.5 milliampere, which is less than 0, right? This means that our assumption for diode number 1 is wrong. Our assumption is wrong for D1. Since our assumption is wrong for one of them, even if it is wrong for one of them, this means that the whole thing is wrong. The whole solution for the whole problem that we did so far is wrong. But my advice to you is, when you repeat assume, solve, check again, keep the diode that was correct, keep it as it is. Keep the assumption for the diode that was correct as it is. So here we found that diode number 2, our assumption was correct. So my advice is, when we repeat again the solution, keep diode number 2 to be on. And change only the one that turned out to be wrong assumption. Change only the diode that turned out to be wrong. This advice might help. It's not guaranteed 100% that it will get you there, to get you to the correct solution directly, but it is like for with high possibility it will give you the correct solution. It's not guaranteed 100%, but this is the best strategy that we know so far. Is change only the diode that turned out to be wrong assumption and keep the other one as it is. This is the best strategy that you can do. It's not guaranteed 100%, but this is the best that you can do. So what we are going to do in the next step is we are going to repeat again. We are going to assume that diode number one is off and diode number two is on. And then in this case, the circuit will look like this. Diode number one is off, which means open circuit. Diode number two, and this is VD1, ID1 in this direction. Diode number two will be on, so short circuit. This is VD2, negative VN positive here, and ID2 in this direction. Then we have a resistance, then a voltage source here, which is negative 10 volt. Okay, this is 5 kilo ohm, this is 10 kilo ohm, and this is 15 volt. Now let's solve the problem. We need to calculate ID2, VD2, ID1, VD1. Of course, ID1 is zero because the diode is open circuit. And of course, VD2 is also zero because we assume this is a short circuit. We assume it's on, short circuit. We need to calculate VD1 and we need to calculate ID2. From this loop, let's take this loop. The current ID2 is the same as the current here. So we can calculate ID2 from this loop. ID2 will be 15 volt minus negative 10 volt divided over the resistors in this loop. 15 minus negative 10, the voltage here minus the voltage here divided over the resistors, which is 10 kilo ohm plus 15 kilo ohm. So 10 kilo ohm plus 15 kilo ohm. This will give you 25 volt divided by, this will give you 25 volt divided by 15, sorry, this is 5 kilo ohm, divided by 15 kilo ohm. So 10 plus 5, okay? So this will be 25 over 15, this is 5 over 3, which is 1.6667 milliampere. We calculated now ID2. Once we have ID2, we can calculate the voltage of this point, the voltage of this point, which is VD1. So we can say that VD1, the voltage of this point, VD1 is the voltage of this point minus zero, minus the ground. So VD1 is the voltage of this point. We can say that VD1 equals 15 minus the drop here. 15 minus the drop over this resistor. So VD1 equals 15 minus the current ID2 multiplied by the resistor 10 kilo ohm. So this will give you 15 minus ID2 is 1.6667 milliampere multiplied by 10 kilo ohm. So this will be 15 minus 16.667 volt. So this will give you minus 1.6667 volt. This is VD1 now, and this is ID2. Now let's check. We assume that diode number one off. And we found that VD1 is less than zero, then our assumption is correct for D1. We assume that D2 is on, and we found that the current ID2 is greater than zero, then our assumption is also correct for D2. So we found that our assumption for D1 and D2, both of them are correct. Then now we solved the problem. We solved the problem, and this is the correct solution of the problem. Because we found that our assumption for both diodes is correct. If you find that your assumption for only one of the diodes is wrong, then your whole solution is wrong. You have to repeat the assumptions from the beginning, solve the problem again, as we said. But as an advice, keep only or change only the diodes that turned out to be wrong, and keep the other diodes with the same status that you assumed before, and change only the diodes that turned out to be wrong. This is an advice to shorten the time as possible. And that's it for this example. We'll see you in the next video, inshallah.